Hi there, this is Lois. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're well wherever you are. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. Okay, quick update on international students in Canada. Okay, and this is for people who are applying. I already did another update of those ones who are already here, but I'm talking about people who already had study permits or who had been approved for study permits before March 18. When the borders were closed, okay? So if you are in that category, if you already had your study permit or you are approved for study permit before March 18, you are exempt to travel to Canada, so you can come to Canada, okay? Thing is, you must pass the health check that they are doing before you board your flight abroad. So you must pass that. Once you pass that, you will be allowed to travel to Canada. And once you arrive here, you are also going to be checked again. And it doesn't matter whether you're showing symptoms or not, you must self-quarantine for 14 days. That is mandatory. So what does that look like? You have two options once you arrive. You can self-quarantine. And to be able to self-quarantine, you need to show them that you have a self-quarantine plan. I have talked about that plan in my previous video about visitor visas, okay? So you must show them that you have that plan to self-quarantine. If you don't have that plan, then the Chief Public Health Officer of Canada is going to send you to a designated quarantine facility. There's no debate. It's either you have a plan or you're going to be quarantined for 14 days, okay? All right, the other question people are asking is whether online courses will affect their eligibility for the postgraduate worker work permit. And that is not going to be affected. So if your classes, if your in-class courses have been moved online, so a lot of universities have moved their studies online, just like the other schools here in Canada. So if you're doing an online only format because of COVID-19, then you'll still be eligible for postgraduate work permit during that time. That is going to be counted as an eligible period of study, okay? So if you have a study permit or you have been approved to study in Canada, and your program is starting, let's say, in May or June, but you cannot travel because of COVID-19 again, because of the travel restrictions, you are still going to be eligible for the postgraduate work permit. Okay? So if you're in that situation, well, you have a few options. And the options, you have two options. So the first option is to begin your classes while you're outside Canada. Okay? And you will need to complete at least 50% of your program while outside Canada if you cannot travel sooner. So you need to talk to your school, and then June, July, May, whenever you're starting, you will need to begin your classes online. Okay? And then you'll need to complete at least 50% of your program while outside Canada if you cannot travel sooner. Okay? Yes, so you do not have to worry if you're already in that situation. The other question that people are asking me is whether they should apply for their study permits. And I'm saying yes, simply because they have not said that they are not processing study permits. Applications are getting processed every day. Okay? Until they say no, they're still being processed. So, if you have an admission already and you meet all the other requirements, you have your school fees, you have everything ready, please proceed and apply for your study permit. Okay? Please proceed and apply. And this is mostly maybe for people who are planning to come to Canada in September. We don't know what's gonna happen between now and September, but they're still going to be approving study permits for September and January. So please go ahead and apply. There's nothing that is stopping you from applying. If this whole situation goes on until that time and you cannot come, then what I've talked about prior is going to apply to you, that you will be expected to start online classes while you're outside Canada, okay? So in the meantime, because we are not there yet, we don't know what's gonna happen in July, August, and September, For now, please apply for your study permit. There's nothing stopping you from applying for that, only that you may not be able to travel. But you know, you already have a study permit and everything else is going to be okay, because you'll be allowed to study online, and that time that you study online is going to be counted towards your postgraduate work permit. So you don't have to worry that, you know what, you already did half of your school online. That time is going to be counted towards your postgraduate work permit. So you can still have your regular postgraduate work permit regardless of how you studied. These are all measures that are, you know, that are being taken because of this COVID-19. This is a new, it's an unprecedented situation. So we don't know. We are all learning and we're getting new things. We are getting new updates every day. Okay? All right. So that is about study permit applications. And yeah, I wish you all the best. If you have any question, please send me an email. My email is going to be in the description part of this video. Okay? Stay safe. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed. Bye now.